Welcome everybody to Children's Liturgy. I'm so glad you could join us today. Today we're celebrating the solemnity of the Saints Peter and Saint Paul. Who were Saint Peter and Saint Paul? Well, Saint Peter was the rock upon which Jesus built his church. He was a source of great strength for the early Christians. Whilst Saint Paul was a missionary, whose main aim was to spread the good news that he had experienced throughout the world. These two disciples of Jesus formed the foundation of our church today, and they were great leaders. Let's begin by putting our hands together and making the sign of the cross, remembering the Holy Trinity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's light our candles as a reminder of Jesus' presence. Jesus said, "Let your goodness shine out like a light in the darkness, so that through you the love of our Heavenly Father will touch the lives of others." It's time for us to examine our conscience and think about, is there anything that we need to say sorry for? So let's place our hands together as I say the prayer. Father, forgive us if we have hurt anyone by our thoughts or actions, and help us to forgive those who have hurt us. We ask this through Jesus our Lord. Amen. Join me as we sing, "I have come to say sorry." We're going to sing our gospel acclamation, "Share Your Word." Let's prepare to listen to the gospel today by making the sign of the cross on our forehead, lips, and heart. Today's gospel reading is taken from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 16, verses 13 to 19. One day, Jesus asked his disciples, "Who do people think I am? Some say you are John the Baptist. Others say the prophet Elijah." Jesus turned to his friends and said, "Who do you think I am?" Peter answered, "You are the Son of God." Jesus smiled and said, "Peter, you are a happy man, because my heavenly Father revealed this to you. You are the rock on which I will build my church." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let's have a little think about Saint Peter. What did Saint Peter do for a living? He was a fisherman, who many believed lived in Capernaum by the Sea of Galilee. Why was he chosen to be the leader of the early church? Well, actually, Peter had been with Jesus from the very beginning, and he had witnessed all of the marvellous things that Jesus had said and done. And he knew that Jesus was indeed the Son of God. And in this way, God chose him to be the shepherd of his flock on earth. And as you can see in our picture on the left, that is a picture of Saint Peter when he started off, the very beginning, as a fisherman. So who is this on the right? Well, this must be St. Paul. What do we know about St. Paul? Well, he was a Jewish Pharisee, and he was very well educated, and actually very religious. He lived in the city of Tarsus, and he had actually never met Jesus, but he really wanted to uphold the Jewish law and the traditions, and so he actually had many of Jesus' followers thrown into prison. He believed he was doing the right thing. But what happened to make Paul suddenly change? Well, one day, whilst on his way to a place called Damascus to arrest some Christians, God appeared to Paul as a brilliant light. The light was so blinding that he couldn't see, as you can see in the picture. And he asked Paul to stop hurting his followers. Paul changed his ways, and instead of being one of the greatest enemies of Jesus, he actually indeed became one of his greatest friends. Did Peter and Paul know each other? Well, they didn't in the very beginning, but eventually they met and became really good friends. They realized that they were both working for Jesus. They traveled far and wide, preaching the good news about Jesus and sharing their Christian faith with others. So why do we have this very special day to remember St. Peter and St. Paul? Well, it's actually because they were two of the greatest leaders in our church's history, and they worked tirelessly to spread that good news. They suffered for their faith, spent time in prison, and yet they continued to do the work of Jesus, writing letters that we can still read today. So we remember them for all of their courage and their braveness for standing up for what they felt was the right thing and to share God's word. So that leads us on to think about, what can we take away from today? How can it help us live our own lives? Well, if we think about the courage that St. Peter and St. Paul must have had to stand up in front of people and to preach that good news, even though when some people didn't accept them, and they must have found it really, really hard, they still did it anyway. And that is what we can learn from this today. So when times are really difficult and really hard, hopefully we will have the courage and the strength, like they did, to stand up for what we believe and to preach the good news. Today's activity is a colouring one. So you will be able to download this picture from Our Lady Queen of Heaven's website, print it off and colour it in. One half of the picture depicts Peter the fisherman, and the other half of the picture depicts Paul the missionary. And hopefully you can place it up somewhere in your homes as a reminder that we too should have the courage like these two people did. Let's end off today by saying our final prayer. Let's put our hands together. Lord, give us the faith and courage of Peter and Paul, and help us in our own way to carry the word of God to others. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us today and spending this special time with us. We look forward to seeing you next week. Take care. Yo.
Yeah.